Okay, so let's unravel the mystery that is the credit score. Imagine it's like the trust meter of your financial life. So lenders or even landlords can look at that score and decide whether to approve you for a loan or an apartment. But how do you make sure it's screaming, "Trust me, I got this"? Let's break it down. Think of your credit score as your financial report card, a number between 300 to 850 that shows lenders how responsible you've been with money. This little number holds a lot of power. High credit scores can get you way lower payments when borrowing money, like for mortgages or a car. It can make renting an apartment smoother and even unlock better credit cards with awesome rewards. Basically, a better score can save you thousands in the long run. So, what makes up this credit score? Let's break down the ingredients. First, you've got payment history, making up 35% of your credit score. This is the heavyweight champion of your credit profile. Always, and I mean always, avoid late payments. They're the quickest way to see your score nosedive. A close runner-up is the amount owed, or credit utilization. This is a tricky one. Borrow too much, and it looks like you can't handle your finances. Borrow too little, well, you could end up with no score at all. You want to demonstrate that you can handle a reasonable amount of debt responsibly. Pro tip, aim to use under 30% of your credit limit, and if you can, under 10% is golden. Next, we've got the length of credit history, which makes up only 15% of your score. The longer you've been borrowing, the better. It's like a trust track record. Lastly, we've got types of credit and new credit, which is worth 10% of your score. That means you want to diversify. It's like having a well-rounded diet, but for your finances. Having different types of loans, car, credit card, or mortgage, shows lenders you can juggle. This is the lowest priority, and you want to be really sure you can be responsible for that debt if you're going to open new credit accounts or get something like a car loan. Take it easy and prioritize the big guys we talked about earlier. Okay, now let's talk about how to become a credit score superstar. First, you've got to start building credit. If you haven't started, now's the time. It's like building muscle. Start small, be consistent. Pay on time and in full. It might sound like a broken record, but it's the song of champions. Don't just stick to minimum payments. Clear that balance each month. Boost your credit line. Every so often, give your credit card company a call. Ask them about increasing your credit line, which can help keep your credit utilization low. Don't close old accounts. Think of them as old friends. Even if you don't want to hang out anymore, they're a valuable part of your history. Okay, last thing I want to leave with you is how to check your score. You can get a free credit report every year from the major credit bureaus. Make it a habit to check annually, and just make sure everything looks accurate. There's some other ways you can stay on top of your credit score too, which you can find in our first Home IQ course on credit. And look, you may already have a totally messed up credit score, but that's okay. That doesn't mean you can't fix it. It'll take time, but I promise you, it's worth it. Talk with a trusted professional if you need it and start taking those steps. Remember, higher credit scores not only make your financial journey smoother, but can also lead to a lot of savings in the future. Take ownership over your financial reputation and own your future.